I know compliance isn't an exciting topic for most people. Usually you hear that word or you hear security and you start to have nightmares about audits and the work that's going to come out of this and that annoying guy from InfoSec who won't be quiet about things you have to have on your servers that he doesn't want. But, you know, it's important. It really is important. And absolutely. I think every time we see, you know, company XYZ on front page news because of breach foo, that should tell you how important security really is. And what do they call those? Resume generating events, right?
Yes, absolutely. That's 100% correct. And if you need to start with understanding what your environment looks like, so you don't have to go through and say, we got to lock everything down immediately and as hard as we can. Start in steps. Start with understanding your organization. Start with just running a benchmark to one of the frameworks, and CIS is a great example of that. So then you can document, hey, at this point in time in my career and or with the organization, we are here. This next quarter, let's see if we can't bump it from like the 67% compliant to, if it's that easy to go to 98% and it didn't cause any major issues, that's a net win for you. That's plan the next quarter to go even more. Got a couple questions?
I think we have a few questions to answer. So go ahead. When performing remediation using OpenSCAP, does it have a negative impact on CPU and memory usage? Will it cause high CPU and memory?
So depending on your environment, if you've got a beefy machine versus an edge device, it's going to differ, right? In some regards, like it was installing aid. It's installing a package. So it's the same amount that if you're going to go yum install, which could be a very little bit, but you need bandwidth then. So if you're in an offline or disconnected network, unless you're pointing to an internal repository, your mileage may vary. So is it going to make it a detriment on everything? No, but there's a small overhead that's going to take to be able to run this.
Yeah, I think this is one of those cases where it's really fair to say it really depends. Depends on what rule set you're applying. It depends on the system you're running it on. Some of those tasks are going to be higher intensity than others. So yes and no. It's hard to say. Hard to say for certain. Do we have any more questions? Oh, go ahead.
It's not going to bring the system down to its knees, was what I would say. There's a slight overhead to it.
Okay. Example, enabling FIPS after install is non-compliance, right?
So that's a fantastic question. When you go into FIPS, this is a whole nother level. We can deep dive more of that on our next episode or when we do the stigging as well, because FIPS compliance stig will go. Once you go FIPS, you can't go back. You're talking about a reinstall. So you've got to go through it. If you're going through that level of effort anyway, it helps to be able to go through and enable that from the start. And typically, whether that's image builder or doing that from install time, it makes it easier. It's not perfect. So if you can do it, if you want to enjoy pain or into that, that's cool. Go for it. You could do a lot of things.
I love stress. Let's do that. Right. Have any more questions?
Absolutely. Some checks are manual. And like I said before, some of these are procedures or policy based and not based off of the just running Ansible or Bash scripts to close this out.
Yeah. OpenSCAP can't institute your InfoSec security program that maybe is part of compliance, right?
Right.
But it can change the password policy on the box, right? So there's certain things that it can't do for you. And I don't know that the OpenSCAP policies even contain rules for stuff that cannot be implemented on a system, right? So if you're following something like disastig and there's things about process or policy, those are harder to automatically deploy. You can't just run OpenSCAP and be like, we're done.
Absolutely, right? It is one step in the process. David's comment saying more examples might be helpful, like creating before and after reports on compliance with the STIG. That's fantastic information. We'll go through and cover that in the future.
More STIG examples, right.